children, welcome to social science class. Today let us discuss second chapter from history. So that is from trade to territory. As the title denotes, British came to India as traders. Their sole purpose was to trade with India. So in this chapter we are trying to understand, so how the British become the rulers of India. In the previous class, previous standard, you studied about Mughal rulers. And who was the last powerful Mughal ruler? Aurangzeb. So Aurangzeb died in the year 1707. And after that, a new political power began emerging in the India, political horizon of India, that is British. And in 1600, English East India Company acquired a charter from Queen Elizabeth. As per this charter, they granted sole right to trade with India. So what is the sole right to trade with India? Trade with East. So no other trading groups could not to compete with English East India Company. So only the English East India Company have the sole right, supreme power to trade with India. So here in India, they sell, they buy the things at cheap price and carry them back to Europe and selling them at higher prices. In this way, they earn a huge profit. That policy is known as mercantile policy. Then in 1498, Vasco da Gama, Portuguese explorer, found a new sea route to India. After that, many European powers came to India, like Dutch, British and French. So what attracted these European powers to India? So that is the world famous silk, cotton and spices like cardamom, pepper, cinnamon, cloves, like that. So when the other European powers came to India, so there will be competition among these trading groups. So that led to increasing the prices of the goods and decrease the profit of the trading companies. And each company tried to eliminate the rival powers. And then these led a battle with them, and they frequently sank the others, regularly sank the ships of the other rival groups, and they blocked the ships and preventing the rival ships moving from the supplies of goods. And then this trade led to a battle, and then they started the fortification to protect their trading areas. So then the English East India Company started trade with Bengal. So and in first factory was in Bengal. The first factory was set up in the banks of River Hooghly. So that factory means a warehouse. And then the company officials persuaded the merchants to live near the factories and the place in which the factories are operated. Then they also bribed the Mughal officials and got the right to zamindari. Then they demanded more and more concessions, like to issue farman, that means a royal order. So they demanded the Mughal ruler as an Aurangzeb to issue farman, and this is a royal order. Then after that, so the rulers in the Bengal, the powerful rulers, like the next rulers, they were refused their demand. And in this time, the Bengal is ruled by the powerful rulers like Murshid Qutub Shah, Ali Baba Shah and Sirajul Daulah. They were denied to grant the concession to the company, and they denied the right to name coins, and they also stopped fortifications and to pay taxes. So then they the company is doing, the company, this company decide. And they what they do, this aspect of the reference to the Nava and humiliating the authority of them. So in this way, this conflict led to confrontation of confrontations, and at that led to the culmination with the battle. So in 1756, Siraju Daula became the Nawab of Ganga. He was a powerful ruler. He asked the company to stop the fortification and stop meddling interfering the political affairs of the Ganga and to pay taxes. And the negotiations failed. And what did Siraju Daula do? He marched with 30,000 of soldiers and captured the English factory at Kasim Basa. And next he turned into Calcutta to capture the company's factory under. So on hearing this news, the company official sent a probe and made a trip of Robert Clive. In 1757, Robert Clive and Siraju Daula fight against Siraju Daula, and in this battle, Siraju Daula defeated. So the main reason for his defeat, his commander-in-chief, Mir Jafar, never fought a battle because the Robert Clive promised him that after crushing the Nawab, crushing the Siraju Daula, he became the new Nawab of Ganga. So this is the important war in Indian history. This was the company's first victory in India. Then after that, Siraju Daula assassinated and Mir Jafar became the new Nawab of Ganga. Democracy move is an important event in the Indian history. Okay, children, so today that is my lecture section, and next day we will continue our class. Okay, thank you.